Thank you for tuning in to our Morning Glory live stream video. I'm your host, Dietrich Hubbard, and today's topic is what's stopping you. What's stopping you? So we've been off the air because of the hurricane. Power was out and just came on a few minutes ago. But watch that. That doesn't stop us. Because we have to understand that things are going to happen. And when they happen, do we have things in place to help us to make sure things still run smooth when mistakes happen? But anyway, that's a whole nother subject. So we're going, what's stopping you? And see, a lot of people are not entering into ministry. They're not entering into relationships. They're not entering into jobs. They're not entering a destiny. They're not entering into their business because something is always stopping them. See, we got an excuse for everything that's stopping us, but we don't have no reason why we still shouldn't move on in the things of God or in the things of our life. You know, just because you had your heart broken once or twice, just because somebody cheated on you, just because you ain't got no money, that shouldn't stop you. We're going to be in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1. It says, therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on unto a perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith toward God. So what we got to understand, what Paul was telling the Hebrews, he said, he said, do we got to keep teaching the same thing over again? Why do the church constantly got to teach people about love? Why we got to constantly teach about submission? Why we got to constantly teach about giving? Why we got to constantly teach about love? Those are the foundational principles that everybody should relate to. But understand Paul's letter, he said, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works, which means every time we start a work in Christ and we go back to repent from it, that work is dead. The reason that work is dead, because we even though we made a mistake, we didn't keep on going in the things of God. So what we have to understand is that it's going to come a time that why you keep preaching the same thing over again. But not only that, Paul, when in verse 2, he explained certain foundational doctrine, principles, doctrine, that we shouldn't have to keep going on. He said, of the doctrine of baptism. Why we got to keep teaching people what baptism is? Everybody should understand that. So why you got to constantly teach baptism and of laying on of hands? Those are principles that every believer should have when they come into the knowledge of who Christ is. So why we got to teach people how to lay hands? We have altar laying class and all that mess. So why you got to keep teaching those things? And a resurrection of the dead. Do you know what Paul was saying? A believer raising the dead should be just as common as a believer paying his tithe. But because we don't have the church in order, because we don't understand the power that Christ left us, we can't even raise the dead. And of eternal judgment, which means why we got to keep preaching about people going to hell and what hell is like? We should be so focused on the thing of God that nothing should hold us back from getting what God wants for us. And he said, now see verse 3, he said, and this will we do if God permit, which means it's nothing wrong with keep teaching that. He said, if God tell you to teach it, teach it. But at the same time, you got to understand, some people teach it because it has been, it's a tradition to teach those type things. And when you find a church to keep teaching a foundational principle of who Christ is, that should let you know they do not have the power of Christ. The power of Christ should come with signs, wonders, miracles. I remember just yesterday I was talking to one of the up and coming prophets, and he was talking about how, you know, ain't nothing going on. Then we began to talk. And I said, hey, do this, this, and this, and that. That boy went and he said, well, when I did what you told me to do, he said, I felt a strong wind come across me, time I finished. What's that saying? That means you got to understand the power of God to teach people how to access the power of God. And what I told her, I said, stop speaking defeat in your life, because the power that you have, it has to come out, but it won't come out if you're not consistent in speaking the right things. Verse 4 says, for it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gift and were made partakers of the Holy Ghost. Verse 5 says, and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come. So what he's saying is, he said it's impossible for you to experience the power of God, experience the goodness of what the word do in your life, and come back and have to repent. Verse 6 says, if they shall fall away, to renew them again unto repentance, seeing they crucify to themselves the Son of God afresh and put him to an open shame. Which means you can run up to the altar all you want to, but Hebrews said, when you keep doing that, you putting Christ to shame. You can't keep running to the altar because you're still a whore. Stop screwing. You can't run to the altar, keep running there talking about you're an alcoholic. Stop drinking. Stop taking drugs. Stop lying. Stop stealing. Stop backbiting. Because you understand the power of God, but the word is telling us that when you do this and people sue, he say you crucifying him afresh. That means he feel the nails all over again. And not only do he feel the nails all over again, he wasn't ashamed when the devil tried to put him on the cross, but he's ashamed that the believer is nailing him right back to the cross. Stop listening to Donnie McClurkin talking about you can fall down, but a just man get back up. Okay, you can get up, but verse 6, every time you get up and run up there, you crucifying God again. Stop listening to this music that's contrary to the word of God. Yeah, you can get up, but you shaming him every time you get up. Kick the nigga out the house. It's a shame to go to church and the preacher talking about what you need to be delivered from, and he's still playing Xbox in his drawers in your living room when you get home from church, and you go in there and cook him dinner. Put the nigga out. How much longer we got to be a fool? Verse 7 said, for the earth was drinking in the rain that come off upon it, and bringing forth herbs meat for them by whom it is dressed, receive blessing from God. Verse 8 said, but that which bears thorns and briars is rejected, and is nigh unto cursing, whose end is to be burned. Do you know what he was saying? He was saying that every time you do something and it reproduce goodness, you get goodness. But every time you do something and you reproduce destruction, you receive destruction. You can't go in there and raise your hand talking about, God, I want all you, I want this and I want that, and go home and do the same thing again. You ain't getting no herbs, meat for them by whom it dress. You getting thorns and briars. Your praise is not being received, because in your heart, you're not through doing what you do. Do you think God received filthy praise? He said obedience is better than sacrifice. You can sit up and praise all night, but when you get through, if he's still laying in the bed, if you still going to visit her on the weekend, it ain't no good. Verse 9 said, but beloved, we are persuaded better things of you, and things that accompany salvation, though we thus speak. Verse 10 said, but God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which you have showed toward his name, and that you have ministered to the saints and do minister. Can't persuade you to keep doing the wrong thing. I got to persuade you to do things that accompany your salvation. We got to make sure that people's souls are saved. Not that they paying tithes and what they wear and what they got on and who they screwing. Yeah, I talk about it, but at the same time, if you doing all that and your soul ain't saved, what good is you doing the things that think your soul saved? Ain't it funny how all these people are consistent tither, and the ones that consistently tithe are the ones that consistently struggle? That should let you know something ain't right. Something ain't right. Watch this. It said, for God is not unright to forget your work and labor of love which you have showed toward his name. That means you're going to do it in the name of God. Make sure you're doing it to your salvation. Don't be doing this to be seen. Watch this. And we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope until the end. That means don't give up when you're doing stuff for God. You know how many people that left me and say, I can't handle this, Deidre. I can't do that no more. The Bible says when you begin to work and you turn your head from the plow, you ain't worthy of the kingdom. Can I be honest? I be wanting to give up. But every time I speak to one person and it changed their life, that's that one person that get to do better, they give me enough fuel to make it to the next time, whenever that may be. Verse 12 said that you be not slothful, but follow them who through faith and patience inherit the promises. Watch this. Those that you who would follow me for since I began ministry, y'all see how I can, you see how I used to live and things I used to do and things I used to say. But then you seen the ministry grow. I'm not on here talking about, oh, I can't pay my bills. God, I need a prayer warrior. God, do this. Y'all don't see me saying that. So why do y'all follow people who don't even have faith and patience to inherit the promise? When you sit around here and listen to these people, and they always begging for money and just the other day, I did a few things and helping people, and money came in. I heard the Holy Spirit. He said, get everybody that connected to you consistently some money. Ain't your business how many? But it was enough that everybody gave. I said, how much? He said, get them that, get them that, get them that. We did it. Because watch this. What good is it me to inherit stuff and inherit blessings and inherit prosperity and I can't pass it on to the people who believe in me? Watch this. Because if I was like them, watch this, and didn't have nothing, and they sent leaders who had something, and they leaders are always talking about what they got, won't give them nothing, I'd be just like the other people. My wife tell you, Brother Hubbard gave out some money. Because he said, give it to him. You don't hear me talking about I got no pastor anniversary. My anniversary is when God tell me to release something to somebody else that can help them in their time of need. Boy, they was happy. I'm talking about they was happy. Stop following people who you don't see the faith and the promises working in their life. Y'all don't see me begging people to somebody, ooh, help me get this, help me get that so I can do this. If you read the Bible, God allowed people to give to ministry, and when he gave to that ministry, he was able to do ministry. Then when you have understanding the apostolic anointing, people give to that person so he could distribute evenly. I did some distributing in the past, these past 2 days. Even when our life was out, we just came home, throw away all that darn food, and got to go back to the store. But that didn't stop what I told God. I ain't say I ain't finna get them there. We got to go buy food. I did what he told me to do. Why y'all following people who always need prayer, who always ask for that? They're not inherited the promises. I teach people all the time. It's easy to call your leader blessed when all the money going to him. But my objective is that the people I teach and the people that connect to me is that when I reach a level of financial success, I'm able to give to them too. I ain't greedy about no money. Money don't move me, but you take money to do ministry. Watch this. And some of the people didn't even give us nothing. So it wasn't about who gave, it was about who connected and learned. And he said, get them. Because they consistently want to know the truth. You watch this. That's kingdom work. Verse 13 said, for when God made promises to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swore by himself. Verse 14 says, surely bless I will bless thee and multiply I will multiply thee. God understood that he told Abraham, he said, if you don't believe in nobody else, believe in me. And when you get to the point where I see your belief, I'm going to bless you and multiply you. Same thing here. If I got to a place, I ain't never did nothing like that. But he had me at a place, he said, give. Huh? When the last time your leader, your overseer, huh? Your pastor, your prophet, when the last time they just gave you because God said, they always take it. Kingdom. See, the reason things stopping you from going where you need to go is because you following people who ain't inherited the promise. They talk about the promise. They pray about the promise. But they ain't inherit the promise. See, when you inherit the promise, you ain't got to always ask for nothing. It just happened. My wife would tell you, when I was giving away money, money was still constantly coming in. I started giving away more. God ain't going to give you nothing if he can't trust you to do the right thing. Y'all following people because they got a reputation, but they ain't got no salvation. I would listen to the girl talk about Brian Kahn and how he just did her wrong. And then all the religious people, oh, he just a man. No. When I was preaching and still messing with women, I knew what I was doing. So like I told them, that ain't no excuse. He just being a man. He know better. Right here talking about, I'm waiting on the Lord before I do anything and screwing anything with a hole. He know better. You, meaning whoever listened to this, you, gonna have to come to a place and you gonna make a list. What's stopping me from getting married? What's stopping me from operating in ministry? What's stopping me from owning my own business? What's stopping me from having a relationship? You're going to have to list that down. And whatever's stopping you, you got to unblock it. We in a season that God really want to bless us. But if you want to screw more than you want salvation, screw on. If you want to drink more than you want salvation, drink on. You want to lie, manipulate, steal more than you want to sell? Go ahead on. But there's a place for you. It's called hell. What's stopping you? Y'all be blessed. Have a good day.